I'm at the base of Mount Muhabura and we are going all the way to the peak, 4,127 meters. Of course, the journey takes about 12 kilometers itself because you've got to go around. But as you can see, I'm ready with my gear and my support system. This locally is known as Enkoni. So we are going with a group of Wildlife Authority and some other good people. We are going all the way to the top to have fun, explore Uganda, but also raise money for Grace Villa Orphanage. Standing at 4,127 meters above sea level, Mount Muhabura, also known as Mount Muhabura, is the third highest mountain in the Virunga Ranges, along the northern border of Rwanda, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and Uganda. Muhabura means the guide in the language of the Bafumbira, the indigenous community in Kisoro district where the mountain is located. The name is also possibly tethered to the historical use of the mountain to aid navigation by the early settlers. 60 of us set out to climb the mountain in a campaign to raise funds for Grace Villa, a girls' orphanage in Kabale district. As we prepared for the hike, we engaged in some warm-up drills.
There, you raise your right leg, raise your right leg. Right leg, get your balance, get your balance, get your balance, take it to the side. Take it to the side, take it to the side. Back to center. And take it back and fly.
A team of medical personnel was at hand to mentally prepare us for the physical expectations and to give us tips on how to deal with any eventualities.
If you feel tired, like you can rest a bit. If you can make it still up, it's fine. If you think you can't continue, still breathless, headache, you're vomiting, all that, you might choose to calm down.
Many in the group were first-time mountain hikers, but exuded confidence and looked forward to making it safely to the top of the mountain and back. Shortly after 9 a.m., the trek began. For many of us, the start was a walk in the park. We strode along with relative ease. But as the ascent continued and time lapsed, the task soon became grueling. The more the climbers ascended, oxygen became less and their energies dissipated. Climbing a mountain is pretty much like a marathon. It is wise not to begin at a high speed. But many either didn't know this technique or ignored it, and soon they were grasping for breath. Yet the more arduous task was still ahead of them, or rather above them. The Muhabura mountain climb has two major stops before the peak, each with a resting hut. The first hut is at 3,116 meters above sea level, while the second is at 3,855 meters above sea level. Most of the climbers stopped at the first hut, rested a bit, had a party of sorts as they munched away on their packed lunch, and then returned to the base.
I'm not there.
This?
At times when I question my existence,
this is clear.
Is it really me?
But for others, after a short breather, they soldered on to the second hut and called it quits. Beyond the second hut is when, in the words of one hiker, life became complicated. The mist didn't help matters and the cold became unbearable. I made it to the peak after 5 hours and 50 minutes of a tough but fun hike. Out of the 60 climbers that set out at the base of the mountain, just 12 of us made it to the peak of Mountain Muhabura.
Finally, after 5 hours and 50 minutes, I finally made it to the peak of Mount Muhabura. As you can imagine, I'm in excruciating pain. I've not done something that is as arduous and as grueling as this, but it is very rewarding. So this is for the signpost that shows the altitude here, and at the very back, that is where the crater lake is, the Muhabura crater lake. This is awesome. The Uganda is clearly very beautiful. You want to make it here. Not many of our colleagues have made it. I can count a few of us that have been able to. You've got to keep encouraging yourself and to keep going. But finally, we have made it. And who knows, maybe next time it could be Mount Everest. I don't know. So we'll see how things go. Of course, now the hard task is to get back to the base. I'm told it's a little bit harder. But after getting it this far, we'll make it down.
On the way back to Kampala, we made a quick stop to take in the beauty at Lake Bunyonyi, the Lake of a Thousand Birds. As we left, some youngsters were at hand to bid us farewell.
Joel, those kids.
Hey, hey.
The trip to Kisoro was more than worthwhile. We participated in a noble cause, raising funds for Grace Villa Orphanage, beheld the beauty that Uganda is in this southwestern part of the country, and for most of us, climbing Mount Muhabura was an item ticked off our wish list. Joel Ssenyonyi, NTV.